This is about as fucking, this is about as close to like a fucking 1980s hardcore show as I can fucking remember. That's the fucking kids in the basement. That's what it's all about. The only thing that's different from the 80s tonight is we didn't have social media back then. So when you're taking all those pictures, fucking send them to Cro-Mags. I want to fucking remember tonight. This is gonna be fun. Y'all ready? How many people are seeing us for the first time? All right, this goes out to y'all. We'll be right back. Way back now. Back to before a lot of your parents met. That's how old I am. But let me tell you something. Anybody who tells you that getting old sucks ain't doing it right. I am motherfucking 57, and I feel great. So, don't fucking believe the hype, man. You know what? Do your best to fucking live a good life. Do your best to live a fucking healthy life. A positive life. You know? I spent a good most of my life being a really fucking negative, hostile, mean motherfucker. And honestly, it really had a lot to do with the shit I was subjected to as a kid, you know? But no one's life is easy, and everybody goes through a lot of shit. And at the end of the day, you really gotta find your way, man. You gotta find your way through that madness. And I'm just glad I'm alive and here today, man. This next song goes out to, I got a lot of friends in the Ukraine who are fucking fighting for their fucking lives, for their homes, for everything. And I was thinking about them a lot on the last few tours, and all the people in Gaza who are going through all kinds of fucking hell. But just wait a second, I'm not getting political on this. I'm not one of these motherfuckers who like, oh, this, that, the other. Look, man, people just, look, man, I'm not even gonna go there because they've been in deep shit for a long time, and it's a cultural thing too. I have a hard time sticking up for anybody who oppresses women and still believes in like killing homosexuals and shit like that. So, but that being said, I am against the war, and I'm against oppression, and I'm against any kind of war. Okay, it's really designed by rich people to keep them rich and to keep poor people fighting each other. So I'm not taking sides in any of this shit because we're all humans, and no one should be getting fucking killed and fucking bombed, fucked up. But sadly, world peace can't be done. And we'll be right back. Is it hot enough in this basement for you? I'm gonna do some songs about the streets I grew up in. And like I was saying before, you know, we all make a lot of mistakes. I don't know if I said this before, but I've said it a lot on tour. We all make a lot of mistakes in life. I made more than most people, but you know, you gotta fucking recognize it sooner or later. That's when you start trying to fucking make some changes. I was a fucking asshole when I was young. I wrote fucking albums about the asshole that I was. I was a violent fucking fuck up, man. And I am seriously trying to fucking tell people that's not the way, man. Don't be the fucking asshole that I was when I was a kid. A lot of people fucking tried to follow the Cro-Mags footsteps. A lot of people, oh, they're tough guys, oh, they're getting fights, this and that. That shit was because I was a fucking young kid who had a lot of problems. I was subjected to a lot of physical abuse, mental abuse, fucking violence, sexual abuse. I was molested a lot. All that shit fucking fucks your head up. And I took it out on the rest of the world because I didn't know how to handle it. And all I can try to do is redeem myself now and try to tell people that's not the person that I was in my heart. That's the person I became because I didn't know how to deal with life. And I just fucking, you gotta lead with love, man. You gotta lead with love, man. You gotta try to be a positive man. I was a real asshole. But the thing is, I got a lot of friends who are real assholes too, and they haven't realized it yet. You know? That's the most important thing, is looking in the mirror. Thank you for listening. That was called New Streets. We'll be right back. See, unlike a lot of the old New York bands, those lyrics were fucking real. I can tell you exactly about that day that I woke up with that fucking cop with that gun on my fucking forehead. And a lot of people used to write all these fucking street lyrics, and motherfuckers were like from the suburbs and shit. My shit was legit. My shit was legit. And you know what? Yeah, man. Fuck those old days and fuck the Lower East Side. Lower East Side sucked. I hated it. I used to have to fucking fight every day. That shit ain't fun. I mean, you convince yourself it is, but it ain't fun when people try to kill you for no fucking music. Yeah, this song goes out to that period of my life when I start trying to make some changes. It's called Days of Confusion. We'll be right back.
Yo, Syracuse, I love you guys, man. Seriously, he's lying. He was talking so much shit about Syracuse earlier. One of my best friends in the whole world, Corey Coleman, is the drummer Slapshot, lives here. And I got so many great memories of Syracuse over the years. And I just want to thank everyone of you for coming out on a Monday night. It means a lot. Thank you.
He was talking so much shit about all that.
I fucking love Syracuse.
That's because he's from Boston.
I'm just fucking with all of you. You know what? I don't give a fuck where anybody's from, quite honestly. I don't give a fuck where you're from. I don't give a fuck about much that you think about. As long as you're having a good time and you ain't giving anybody else a hard time, we're cool. Honestly, I don't give a fuck what you believe, what you, you know, because beliefs change. I don't give a fuck what your politics are, because they change too. You know what? The only thing I care about is whether you're an asshole or not. And, you know, you can believe some stupid shit and still be kind of cool. You know, everybody has their good and bad qualities, you know. So, you just, I think the real problem today is that we've all become a victim of the fucking soundbite culture. Nobody fucking thinks anymore. They just grab the nearest soundbite that serves their personal feelings. So it doesn't have to be true or not. It just has to go along with whatever shitty mood you're in. So fuck soundbites and fuck stupid people. Actually, not fuck stupid people. Help stupid people. Educate stupid people. Because I was the stupidest of the stupid. So, you know, we all got a chance.
Are you going to go back again? Oh, are you fucking sorry? You're trying to cut the set short. You guys are
pissed off.
I just offended everybody.
We're in Syracuse. It's all right.
See, I'm old, man. I still like offend people just all day by accident because I'm just still stupid.
Pipe in.